glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Ohio State's been the talk of college football so far. Emphasis on so far. Way too early to think about Crystal footballs and big-time postseason games. You have to maintain your focus if you want to stay on top. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Gathered here at Ohio Stadium on Woody Hayes Drive in Columbus. And now it's time for the Colts, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Ohio State is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Kent State's got a new coach at the helm here in this one, Herbie, and you got to wonder what kind of impact that's going to have. Players will always want to sell out for a new coach, so I expect an emotional game and a lot of big plays.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Some room. Gets to around the 42. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. For extra yardage.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
From the 45-yard line, it's second down. Nice run to the left there. One of the top stadiums in the nation. This crowd comes to play themselves.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field.
And he's level at the 22-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. Hands it off. He gets hit out of bounds at the 20-yard line.
Cooper's the kind of guy that's work ethic really pays off. Right now, he's playing some special football and leading the conference statistically.
Tackle at the 5-yard line.
15 yards.
it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That brings him second and goal.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He's scrambling, decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. They weren't able to defend the quarterback scramble, and they give up 6.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 7-0. Glass looks ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Buckeyes know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 46-yard line. Kirk, you and I have talked to the coaches. We've talked to his teammates. Everybody says this kid's a real deal. We're about ready to find out. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. That's a great tackle at the 36-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
Catches it, he's immediately tackled behind the line. That'll be a 2-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. He's at the 30. The ball pops free. Picks up the fumble. And he hits him hard at the 20.
Man, that is a tough break for the offense. You connect with your wideout hoping to make a play, and he winds up losing control of the ball. Man, that hurts.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
He's got it out snap to his tight end. Tackle right around the 20. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 20-yard line.
And two, go!
Pitch is back. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. The halfback took the pitch but couldn't find any running lane.
And there were no running lanes because this defense had so much penetration into the backfield. He would have been lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Passes it, and it's picked off by the safety. Nice pick by the safety.
Safety that time just sitting back there looking at the quarterback, and once it was thrown, he knew exactly where it was going, and he made the pick.
First and 10. Ball on the 13. Kent State is up by a touchdown. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
And he is drilled at the 13-yard line. From their own 13-yard line, it's third down. I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. Gets it. He's in space. It's going to be fourth and inches after that long pickup on third down.
Well, what a throw by the quarterback. Almost equally excellent catch by the receiver, but the defense topped them both by coming up with a stop.
Smith is waiting for the snap. They'll bring him down at midfield. Golden Flashes are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Nice run there.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
From the 46-yard line, second down.
I smell fear in that offense. Red 2. Blue.
Brought down right around the 44-yard line. Jackson comes away with 2 yards on the quarterback keeper. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
That is not easy to stop. The quarterback hit his man on an out route, and the defender was in man coverage. As a defender in man coverage, you cannot get beat deep. And as a result, the underneath routes are going to be there. And as you can see, it worked out great for the offense as they were looking for a new set of downs.
Nice run up the middle. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 7-0, Kent State. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. And he's taken down right around the 22-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. He might have a chance. And they push him out around the 10-yard line. need to find a way to get points this trip in the red zone. Here's an opening. They'll bring him down around the 1 yard line. It's second and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. And he can't get away from the pressure.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Still 8 yards away. Now it's third and goal. Slings it. Tackle made at the 3 yard line. Lee picks up about 5 yards on that hookup.
That brings us fourth and goal.
It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Ohio State is lining up to kick this one off. Excellent kick. Brought down at the 21-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. They come out in a 5-wide set. He's got it with room to run. He's taken down at the 30-yard line.
That's good for yards. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Kent State holds a 4-point lead. Tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Make the stop at the 31-yard line.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
Second down and 14. Ball on the 31-yard line. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Youngblood is the deep man awaiting the return. Youngblood fields it at the 26.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They get nice yardage on that run. Henderson gets 7 yards on the play.
That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And down he goes at the 47. Rid of this one.
Man left.
Second and 10. Ball on their own 47.
Black five, black five.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
Well, I think calling the plays, you've got to be aware of this guy. He's making too many plays. And when he's that close to the line of scrimmage, defending the run, not allowing your running back to even get up to the line of scrimmage, you've got to do something to make him pay for that. If he's going to cheat up to the line of scrimmage, if you're calling the plays, listen up. This is a great time to go play action and try to throw the ball right over top of his head.
He's tackled at the 44. Carson waiting the return. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Kent State is up four. He fights forward to about the 23. Kent State's going to use their first time out of the half here. About 2 minutes before halftime. And he's going to be sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Really a tough spot for an offense to be in against this crowd in this stadium. Carries the ball for a nice game. Nice defensive stand there.
And some good play calling defensively. They always had someone in the right spot to make a play and force the three and out.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Tackle at the 42. Ohio State's coaching staff, I've got a thing going into halftime, and we're getting close right here. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running backs just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback and an offense is tested. Their star players not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now as we're close to this half, now is when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack to be able to put points up.
Man can't tack on any yardage.
Easy, easy. Flag.
Caught and shoved out of bounds. It's first and 10. Ball on the 17. Gets out to about the 15-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself. It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
The kick is up, and it is good. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
Time to have a look at what's going on in East Lansing. And for Michigan State, we've got a little drama starting to unfold right now. A potential major upset in the making. Eastern Michigan leads it 17-14.
7-6 in our game here. Ohio State gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Kent State with a one-point lead. Caught out in the open.
He's to the 40, and he's shoved out of bounds
right around the 42-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 17 yards. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Pressured and brought down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today. Throws it, and he's got the tight end again. Tackle around the 48-yard line. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gain, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there, and one of his guys can come down with it. He wants it all, going long. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. We head into halftime with both offenses struggling. The Golden Flashes in front, 7-6.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
He's to the 40. And he's tackled at the 47. First and 10, ball on the 47. He fights forward to about the 46.
Gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
And they hit him in the backfield.
Loss of 4 yards on the play. That'll make it third and 13.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. Brought down around the 30-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 27-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 27-yard line. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. This is the eighth play of the drive.
Check three, check three, check three. Oh, four.
Touchdown, Bucks. So the offense is going to go for two. Scrambling, and they won't get the two. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Off to University Park we go.
The Nittany Lions
deliver the perfect connection and a touchdown. And for Irons, he's having a sensational day with three touchdowns. The Zips have the lead, 24-21.
Reese, great game here. It's going to go to the wire, it looks like. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. The Buckeyes continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Call it again 5 yards. That brings them second and five.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Fires to the wideout, first down. They'll bring him down at the 37-yard line.
Number two with the tackle at the 37-yard line. First down.
Let's go!
Now he tries to buy some time. And he hits him hard at the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. He makes it to the 48-yard line. He's on the run. Tackle made around the 43-yard line.
Gain of 9 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 43-yard line. First down.
Here we go. Ready, cut.
And he's tackled at the 44-yard line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
That'll bring
overthrown. I don't think he got anything on that. Here's the eighth play of the series. Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Here we go.
85, I'm coming for you. Coming for you. Here we go.
Nice run there. Cooper gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and six.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. 95 is mine. 95. Let's go.
Somebody jumped early down there.
Offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 26.
Ready.
And he's taken down at about the 31.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
Fires it out, and they make the stop at the 17-yard line. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost them the possession. See this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
He's taken down at the 31. From their own 31-yard line, first down. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. Tackled around the 42-yard line. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9.
That brings up second and 1.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. Throw out to the receiver. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Rid of this one. This one should be interesting.
Pass interference. Defense.
I think he was just a little bit over-anxious in his coverage. You've got to learn to time that perfectly to avoid getting called for it.
From the 10-yard line, it's first down.
Red 2, kill, kill. Panther 2.
Gets to about the 8-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. Ohio State's lead is 5. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The Buckeyes always knew that this kid was going to have a great career. Highly recruited. There's his first touchdown. Not sure there's going to be many more. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 83-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Ohio State is ready to kick it away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're about set to spins up again. Pitches back. He's got the corner. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 40.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 40. It's the tail. And they'll get him in the backfield.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Tackle at the 48.
Gain 10 yards. Third down.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team. And he's stopped behind the line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Smith is waiting for the snap. It's away. Short punt. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 30. Makes it to the 41. The 39-yard line. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, he's right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
Bring up second and 12.
Second and 12 coming up here.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Reset, tight right. 85, I'm coming for you.
Head two, three, nine.
It's just me and you.
Got the corner. He takes it right side for a good game. Complete. Brought down around the 16-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Touchdown, Buckeyes. Ohio State's been telling anybody that would listen that this kid really has what it takes to be a star. He's always going to remember that first touchdown. I'm sure he's going to have a lot more. Great moment, though, for him and his family. And he hits the PAT. A six-play, 70-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So our score, 26-7. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Five wide. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. He scrambled. Come out in a five-wide set. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. A little toss across the middle. They'll bring him down at the 37.
Unbelievable pass. They don't care what down it is.
First down.
By 17, by 17. Watch twist, watch twist, watch twist. Twist, twist. Ready. Green, 19.
Steps up and goes down. Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Now he's scrambling. Tackle made at the 38.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll make it 39.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Quick strike, and he drops it. Well, they're looking for another fourth down conversion. They've already gotten one this drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Here comes the pressure. Airing it out long. And he's hit immediately.
That makes it first and 10.
heaves it to the end zone. Can't connect. He overthrew the intended receiver.
Oh, boy. They take a shot here at the end zone, and he just let that one get away from him.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they hit him in the backfield. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Wants it all. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. He was that close to making a big play.
His safety is kicking himself for dropping that one.
Fires out to his receiver. He's tackled in the open field. They push him out around the 8-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
And this is the 14th play of the drive. Just under 2 to go in the game. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's shoved out of bounds just outside the goal line.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
This is the 16th play of this drive. They go with a run, and he brought down in the backfield. From the 4-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a goal line set. And he's tackled at the 5-yard line. Kent State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. And this is the 18th play of the drive. And he's level at the 12-yard line. Kent State's going to have to use their second timeout of the half. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. They got him, and they'll take over on downs. This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Taken down around the 26-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes us 3.
Ohio.
Ohio State staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.